very warm welcome to Ibadat. Thank you, honored guests, Mr. Sen, Rubalda, Reena, and Abhishek, for inaugurating this very special event by launching our books. Thank you to each and everyone present here. Your presence means a lot to us. This is the very first performing arts event at BCAF. Reena launched BCAF a few days earlier with the visual arts by Kaustubh Chakraborty. The beautiful art is all around this gallery for your viewing. But as a performance arts event, this is the very first show. We are truly honored, Reena. Thank you so much for this. We are also very grateful to Abhishek Ganguly and Team Learning Services for coming on board as the filming and framing partner. We are honored. Both the books that were launched here this evening will be available for sale post the event, and Shubhadra and I will be very happy to sign the books for you. They're there at the other end of the room. So post the event, do please come and meet us. Also, we'd request everyone to give their bites. The camera person will be placed in the adjoining room. So just before you exit, we'd love to hear both about the book, those who've already got it, who've read it, and about the event. Now, for Ibadat. This evening is all about a jugalbandi, a duet of poetry and music. I will be reading mostly from my book, Why I Write Poetry. I'll be reading some from Shubhadra's book, Embers and Ashes. I'll also be reading from some of my other book, even a bit of Fairs Ahmed Fairs. And Shubhadra will be on vocals, ably accompanied by Shubhrajyoti Sen on the sarod. We hope that our poetry and music will flow into one another, will flow together, will flow into you as our offering, our prayer, our ibadat. Does everything have to have a reason? Do we ask about the change of seasons? Why some love the rains and some fear it? Why some feel cold while others don't? Oh yes, you could say science delves into it, finding cause and effect. Debate climatic changes and environment. But try looking at the rainbow and tell me what you see. Beauty, hope, colors, dreams, love. Or some cause and effect. Who knows why I write poetry? Some strange chemical imbalance it must be. All I know is that she comes to me. I don't know when, how, why, but she does. She comes to me. On a beautiful moonlit night, I would hope, when the stars spangle the sky and the Neanderthal and Homo erectus discovered the beauty of fire, the art of science, poetry must have come to me then. And then again, when the sages of our ancient land strung together the shlokas and passed it one to another in ancient rhymes, that's when poetry came to me. She came to me in love through Romeo and Juliet, through the love song of J. Alfred Prufrock and Jivanananda's Bonalata Sen. Yes, she did. Poetry landed within me like a coveted itch, like a silent song, like a wild dance, like the calm after the storm, like my forever lover, poetry comes to me, and I take her in big gulps, in tiny sips, in tenderness and in stress. I take her in love and in faith, in the depths of my fold, in the lightness of my being, in benediction, in revelry, in a celebration. That is she, my poetry.
বহে নিরন্তর অনন্ত আনন্দ ধারা, বহে নিরন্তর অনন্ত আনন্দ ধারা, বাজে অসীম নভ মাঝে অনাদি রব জাগে, অগণ্য রবি চন্দ্র তারা, বহে নিরন্তর অনন্ত আনন্দ ধারা। একক অখণ্ড ব্রহ্মাণ্ড রাজে পরম একুশে রাজ রাজেন্দ্র রাজে, বিশ্বেত নিমেষ হত বিশ্ব চরণে বিনত লক্ষ শত ভক্ত চিত বাক্য হারা, বহে নিরন্তর অনন্ত আনন্দ ধারা, বহে নিরন্তর অনন্ত আনন্দ ধারা।
Under the starlit sky, amidst the August gathering, Raga Yaman in all its abhushan played to a glorious crescendo. Within me, your memory played music to my heart. It built up the mesmerizing music on the mellifluous santur of the maestro. And you, behind my eyes shut, your fragrance lingering under the night sky. No one and nothing existed. Only Raga Yaman played to its exaltation, and you, overwhelming each of my senses. And we existed in an inverted parabola. From the skies to the earth, you and I, in a locked chamber in the heart of the universe, unseen, unheard of, unfelt to all but the music of the tender night sky. Only Yaman played in all its abhushan, felt us in every pore of the universe as we unfolded together within its beautiful rhythm. Morning came to me wrapped in a dense white fog, gliding in amidst the mountains. The tall pines stood strong, a deep green, golden tipped in the morning sun. The pink orchids smiled up at me, with the promise of a warm hue that seemed true. The morning embraced me with love. The dense white, the deep green, the warm pink floated around on the wings of a beautiful butterfly. And my cup of tea felt easy, as if life had its own path, its own mooring, and we, in our callowness, ceaselessly, tirelessly, uselessly, fight to understand patterns beyond our ken, our mortal shortcomings. If only we could trust the ebb and flow of nature in her glorious gift of love. Dreams, between your shadow and my abyss, between the play of light and darkness, between the thousand buzzes that continuously fill our lives, somewhere within your raw, wounded heart and the incessant hammering in my head, somewhere within your lost offspring and my unborn child, somewhere within what should and should not be, we found ourselves between love and within it. like a deep bleeding gut that threatens to overflow, but also like a young gurgling spring that heals and heals us both. And you throb in my thoughts, in my touch, in my heart, in the cells of my being. This then is it. This moment hung in time. Nothing backward, nor forward, nor wayward. We live 1,000 lives over in this one moment, savoring it between and within us. We roll it over. This love in our minds, beyond our mountaintop and seashore dreams, even as we know that this throb, this touch, this life is ephemeral. And you will go up in your cigarette smoke, and I will drown in my Diet Coke. रात यूं दिल में तेरी खोई हुई याद आई, जैसे वीरान में चुपके से बहार आ जाए, जैसे सहराओं में हौले से चले बादे नसीम, जैसे बीमार को बेवजह करार आ जाए. लॉस्ट With, within, without you. My memories mingled with the midnight moon and sought refuge in a soft fragrance that had long passed to a different shore. I stood alone, looking ahead, my mind playing games with the headiness of your fragrance. But didn't you once say you were a part of me and will always be? Of forever promises thrown up in the air and tossed away to morbid realities on the bedrock of earthy brutalities? Yet you will remain within me, your heartbeat fluttering in my own. Your thoughts rush in like the wildflowers over the relics, like the soft breeze in the barren desert. And I am but so lost in you. The midnight moon and I in a fit of madness called love.
No, Rana, Re. আজে বৈশাখে হঠাৎ কেন ডাকলে বলো আজ বৈশাখে রাত্রে জাগা স্বপ্নে তুমি নূতন আমাকে হঠাৎ কেন ডাকলে বলো আজ বৈশাখে আকাশ বাজে বিরোহী সুরে তুমি না হয় রইলে দূরে আকাশ বাজে বিরোহী সুরে তুমি না হয় রইলে দূরে তোমার স্মৃতি আঘাত সম অতীত সে ডাকে অতীত সে ডাকে হঠাৎ কেন ডাকলে বলো আজ বৈশাখে অশান্ত সে সময় তুমি কতই গান গেয়েছিলে তোমার তরে ছেলে মামি আমায় বৃথা চেয়েছিলে অশান্ত সে সময় তুমি কতই গান গেয়েছিলে তোমার তরে ছেলে মামি আমায় বৃথা চেয়েছিলে ছলো না যত তোমার লাজে রেখেছ মোর প্রাণের মাঝে ছলো না যত তোমার লাজে ছলো না যত রেখেছো মোর প্রাণের মাঝে নাই মানিলে ফিরে দা প্রণয়ের বাঁকে প্রণয়ের বাঁকে হঠাৎ কেন ডাকলে বলো আজ বৈশাখে রাত্রে জাগা স্বপ্নে তুমি নূতন আমাকে হঠাৎ কেন ডাকলে বলো আজ বৈশাখে
Woman am I? I am Draupadi, unleashing my hair, breathing fire unto the universe. For I can no longer contain within me this raw agony. Oh yes, I want to bathe my hair in blood. I want to tie it with the entrails of the men who wrong me, O universe. Stand by today as witness, as I vow to avenge where you have wronged me in the name of men who burn us, rape us, steal from and of us, humiliate us, dishonor us, for they have always pawned us for their own insecurities. Miserable creatures who watched Sita walk through fire and disappear into the caverns of Mother Earth. Those who plunder into me, uninvited, unwanted, intolerable. I stand today as Chinnamasta, as Chamunda, as Kali, wild, naked, raw, true, thirsty for Adi Shakti, for Ardhanarishwar, for Shiva, for Satya. I wait to be adorned in truth and honor. I do not wish to listen to him. It's no good, and he knows that. I do not wish to let him speak. Doesn't he know? For his tongue reeks of his hormones, his bloody flesh. It's him, everywhere that speaks. His words hitting against the skin, leaving marks of an unsolicited attention. Where has the lovely man disappeared, who came the other day singing notes, turning from the assertion of the fifth back to the natural third, the fourth, long augmented, now caressing the wounds? Where has the lovely man disappeared, who went unnoticed, for his notes were yet to resonate with the wounds?
Jena rana re rana no rana re rana re rana na a rana re rana.
On lilac nights, you creep in on me yet again. A soft sigh and a silent moan, denting my equilibrium with a soft knock on the hardened door of my heart. Look, are you looking at her the way I did when I called you from that wretched treehouse on that night of the mad moon? Tonight too, I miss you in my moon gaze through the rustle of the dark leaves as they caress the sky softly, reaching up to touch that perfect orb of love, light and delight, this lilac madness of my moon.
Mm-hmm.
Fields shining bright at night, and within my adolescence that harbored notes breathing life into the vibrations of Chandni Kedar, I was drawn to the gentle soft smile she wore and lost myself in her affection earned hard. A day's wait wouldn't be unrewarded. She smiled, augmenting my emotional insecurity a little. And I watered it in acute fears night and morning, till it bore me the fruit, till my tears drowned me in gratitude as a voice pierced through my wounds to rupture me further with her momentary rage. She was not my friend nor my sister, should you ask. She was no one, no one I would ever acknowledge. I choose to keep her obscure, where my ailing heart still responds to my fading memories of her. I have treasured her warmth I have left behind, her touch buried remote in William Blake's garden, her rage cherished deep within my unseen fears, and her voice underlining my dulcet dreams.
Treading on the black path amidst the black trees, swirled in the black mist within the black forest, and with black in our hearts, we plod on. Each black day, toppling into the next, sucked into a black vortex, we plod on till you come at the end of the tether with a cloak of orange-yellow glow and the touch of the sun that wraps us in a curtain of light, and ensconced in the bright, the black-hued yellow sprouts hope, sprouts green, sprouts dreams. The mist twirls, the trees sway. Sunset blazes into my forest and it sets my heart on fire.
অন্ধকারের উৎস হতে উৎসারিত আলো, সেই তো তোমার আলো, সকল দ্বন্দ্ব বিরোধ মাঝে জাগ্রত যে ভালো, সেই তো তোমার ভালো। অন্ধকারের উৎস হতে উৎসারিত আলো, সেই তো তোমার আলো, সকল দ্বন্দ্ব বিরোধ মাঝে জাগ্রত যে ভালো, সেই তো তোমার ভালো। পথের ধুলায় বক্ষ পেতে রয়েছে যে গেহ, সেই তো তোমার গেহ। পথের ধুলায় বক্ষ পেতে রয়েছে যে গেহ, সেই তো তোমার গেহ। সমর ঘাতে অমর করে রুদ্র নিঠুর স্নেহ, সেই তো তোমার স্নেহ। অন্ধকারের উৎস হতে উৎসারিত আলো, সেই তো তোমার আলো। বাকি রহে অদৃশ্য যেই দান, সেই তো তোমার দান। মৃত্যু আপন পাত্রে ভরে বইছে যেই প্রাণ, সেই তো তোমার প্রাণ। বিশ্বজনের পায়ের তলে ধুলিময় যে ভূমি, সেই তো স্বর্গ ভূমি। বিশ্বজনের পায়ের তলে ধুলিময় যে ভূমি, সেই তো স্বর্গ ভূমি। সবাই নিয়ে সবার মাঝে লুকিয়ে আছো তুমি, সেই তো আমার তুমি। অন্ধকারের উৎস হতে উৎসারিত আলো, সেই তো তোমার আলো। সকল দ্বন্দ্ব বিরোধ মাঝে জাগ্রত যে ভালো, সেই তো তোমার ভালো।
What do you do when life stones you, dumb, numb, into a dead end? You then don a stony mask to keep away from reality. You slowly become cold, frozen, hard as a rock. Yet you have seen the rock over the mountain top, so strong, so alone, it stands tall. And the cold, hard stone glitters, that diamond solitaire on my finger and in my heart. Stone in your heart, they say. Tell them to see it my way. A single red hibiscus laid on a stone we worship with milk and honey. Shiva, my lord, resides in stone.
Sorry.
The flowers of love will grow in the poisoned soil, wild, free, fragrant. Just you see. Like a rainbow in the sky after a storm, like an oasis in the desert. And then the blossom will grow into a tree. Just you see. Just you see.
If music be the food of love, play on. So melody is a nourishment for love. Poetry is a language of love. It gives expression to love. When these two blend together or amalgamate with each other and form a kind of chemistry, then they transport you from a world of the laukic to the world of the alaukic, a world of bliss in which you would like to, like a kind of quicksand, allow yourself to be drawn in, sucked in and submerged, never to come out of it again. Such was the experience of Ibadat this evening. And of course, this place, BCAF, a wonderful initiative by Reena Dhawan.
Cross-cultural, interdisciplinary initiatives, when different art forms comes together, is important because we know that how art practice itself is such a lonely journey. So when you exchange such things, it becomes, you find your fellow travelers and you find to exchange impulses, ideas, which can actually enrich your own practice. And I think in this time when we're all in our individual islands, it's important that we hold each other and we bring each other conversing through our arts. And I loved the way Ipshita Ganguly, Shubhadra Kullan and Shubhrajyoti Sen brought together the nuances, the subtle nuances, and such intimate spaces. Because we always have this barrier between the spectators and the performers, and at times the nuances are lost. Here I feel the spectators were part of the art, part of the performance, part of every energy, every sweat, every drop of tear. And that is important when you have such exchanges. That only makes it, I feel, something ethereal, something divine.